Hey guys, how's it going? This is Stephen here, aka Vogel Birdson, in the mobile version of Angry Birds 2. Welcome to 2022. Happy New Year to you guys, wherever in the world you might be. Thank you so much for all your support over the past year, for watching my content, subscribing to my channel, supporting me. It's been really fantastic. Thank you so much. Wanted to do a little video looking ahead to what might be in store for us in Angry Birds 2 this year. Now, these are my own personal opinions, predictions, hopes. I don't work for Rovio, I am an Angry Birds 2 content creator, but I'm just a regular player like you guys, and I thought I'd do a little video looking ahead to what we might expect in the future. Who knows what Rovio has planned, but let's just go through it together. This is the main screen of Angry Birds 2, as you know. Let's start off in the top left there with the star rank. Now my star rank is 181, and it doesn't play any part in the game besides being an indicator of player longevity, activity. For those players that have played the arena a lot over the years, they're going to have a high star rank. If you play through the Saga map levels, you get stars there as well. But I think the star rank is going to play a factor in something, some way, somehow, maybe a new feat, some other reward or acknowledgement for a high star rank. Who knows? But I think the star rank, because it doesn't have any real impact on the game, besides maybe from what I've heard, as you progress through the Saga map levels, it might affect the number of feathers you get in the chest there. But we'll see, who knows what they're going to do with that star rank, and it could be this year. Let's check out the daily deals. Now this was introduced earlier, a few months ago during 2021. Let's have a look at my daily deals. Now I use some black pearls to purchase some of the items there. What we'd really like to see, I think, in the daily deals, of course, is the ability to use apples and arena tickets. Now, those are two things in the game that a lot of people are collecting. They're amassing huge amounts of these tickets and apples. And it'd be fantastic to be able to exchange them in the daily deals. The only danger with this, of course, is how Rovio decides on the exchange rate. It could be, I don't know, they might ask for 5,000 apples for 1,000 black pearls or something silly like that, you know what I mean. What I'd really like to see is that a Tower of Fortune Express ticket become more readily available. 2,000 gems, way too expensive. Guys, don't be spending 2,000 gems on the Express ticket. I'd gladly spend 2,000 apples or 500 arena tickets on an Express ticket, that kind of thing. That could be cool. What about the hat shop? Now, we are, of course, likely to see a new hat. So I think we're going to find ourselves seeing some new Mighty Hat sets. Now, this, of course, these guys are only available in the Mighty Eagle Bootcamp shop. Very much a long term for players like me. In order to take advantage of the tiering system, you have to have all the base hats in the first place. In order to get all the base hats, you need thousands and thousands of Mighty Eagle Bootcamp coins, which I don't have, and a lot of people won't have either. So the Dragon Knight set was the most recent one to be introduced. I still have quite a few hats left to fill in order to take advantage of any tiering upgrades available there. So I don't think we're going to see too much change here. We could probably obviously going to have some new magical exotic hats and maybe some smaller hats as well. Give the newer players a chance to level up their slingshot as well there. Piggy Mail and the settings, of course, I don't think they're going to change. So what we should hope to see are more of these promo codes. Now, we've only had one or two promo codes provided by Rovio since it was introduced. I think Red Fan being one of them, which is no longer available, it says it's expired. But it would be good to get some new promo codes, whether it's for gems, feathers, spells, who knows, some other deal. I'm sure we're going to see some new promo codes in 2022. Daily quests and feats. Now, it would be good to see something different here. Maybe they're going to mix things up a bit. Some different quests. Not everyone pays into the daily gem letter, so people are missing out on completing those quests there. It's often difficult to complete the daily challenge sometimes, so I miss out on getting the King Pig Panic, today being a good example. So we might see some revamp there. As far as the feats go, we've had a new set of feats, which are linked to our activity in the arena. This was introduced only very recently. I'm not going to claim any of these until we get a Feather Frenzy. I'm probably going to be doing a video when that happens, so look out for that. But who knows, I think on the whole, the rewards for feats have always been a bit lacking. a bit rubbish, to be fair. Put 2 million pigs for 1,000 black pearls, no. Give us 10,000, 50,000 black pearls, why not, for popping 2 million pigs? What about our treasures? Now the same thing there, maybe they could make the rewards a little bit more attractive. Let's go have a look straight down the middle for one duck. Now under normal circumstances I would press continue to play video advert for the chance of getting the next 10 gems there, but I'm not going to on this occasion. But have a look at the legendary chest, 900 gems for a legendary chest, that's way too expensive, guys. You shouldn't be spending 900 gems on buying a legendary chest, just don't do it. Legendary reward 2%, hopefully they'll look at adjusting the drop rates to give us a better chance of getting something decent out of these chests. At least they changed the minimum of 500 black pearls up to 800 black pearls. That's better than nothing, I guess. But we haven't seen much of a change in the treasure, so hopefully that comes along this year. What about the Tower of Fortune? Now, I have a bit of a love-hate relationship with the tower, as you will know if you've been watching my videos. What I'd really like to see when there's a new hat set and an adventure where you need to get the hats from the tower, I'd love to see that you're guaranteed a hat for reaching a certain floor. We've just finished the Celebration adventure with the new Christmas Coastal Christmas hat set, I forget what it's called now. And a lot of players needing to get Terence's hat from floor 35, they keep reaching it and they keep missing it, and that must be infuriating. That's happened to me quite a lot in the past, particularly when the hats used to be on floor 50, 55. It would be great in the future, and I'd be happy that you get these new hats on those higher floors, but you're guaranteed it once you actually reach that floor, because getting to floor 55 and missing out on the new hat is ridiculous. You should be guaranteed that hat at that level. I'm hoping they would implement something like that in future. The jackpot egg, I would love to see that more readily available, maybe in a daily deal, some sort of super legendary chest, some other prize, who knows. But the egg is it's so elusive. I've been to floor 60 only a handful of times. I've only got the egg a few times in all the years I've been playing it. It'd be great to get that reward somewhere else within the game, perhaps. What about the Saga map? Now, I'm not going to click on there because it takes a while to load up. I'm currently around level 3116-117, on my way to level 3120. Which is the furthest the map, Saga map goes at the time of me recording this. That's just going to keep on and on and on. It would be good to see them mix things up there, maybe some new boss levels. Here's something I would love to see, a two-boss room. Can you imagine that, either in the map levels, maybe a special level, level 4000, or, well, that's going to take a long time, like 4000, but a double boss room, that would be absolutely awesome. Can you imagine that? About the daily challenge in King Pig Panic. Now, this is a hot topic at the moment, although the subject of the difficulty of the daily challenge isn't a new thing. We've been discussing this for years and years now already. But I'm currently on a 456 DC, and it's too difficult for me to complete Terence Trial for today because there's too many pigs in the rooms all spread out leading up to the boss room. I can't even get there with enough birds. Some people have been getting weird and wacky DCs with like a 6 room, 5 room, 6 room, 6 room, 5 room, 4 room, that kind of stuff. So Rovio kind of mixing things up. But what they tell us, that it doesn't necessarily mean it's any more difficult. But it should be that some of those levels should be more straightforward and easy to clear. But I don't think we're going to see too much of a change there. Although this streak on the right hand side over there is kind of redundant for me. Unless I kind of stop playing, or if I keep failing the DC for a few weeks, I'll drop down to a 223 or 234 or whatever it might be, and I might have a chance of getting up to that legendary chest there. The arena. Now, it's been a year actually since the arena got a huge revamp, and we have this new style arena. Quicker, shorter games. The reaction wasn't that great from the community when it was introduced, but I think since then it's fair to say we've adapted, we've learned how to do it. For me, I'm in a bit of a sweet spot. I'm keeping away from the Master League and enjoying all the rewards that I get on a daily basis. So I get a legendary chest once a day, basically, as long as I can get up to the fourth streak there. And I have a strategy as well around the end of the seasons and the start of the next seasons. I drop myself down so I get a good chance of winning some gems at the end of the week. I don't think we're going to see too much change there. I wonder if they would ever consider something like a Super Streak. We still have the Arena Super Streak on the Windows version of Angry Birds 2, and that's quite interesting with more awards there. But on the whole, I don't think we're going to see too much change in the arena. About the Mighty Eagle boot camp. Now, we talked about those Mighty Eagle hat sets that are only available in the shop there. I don't think we're going to see too much change, to be honest. They might consider revamping it. Let's see where I ended up. I think yesterday, see, position zero. I logged a score and it was zero, and it was asking me to pay 60 gems again to continue. So I'm not going to do that. What am I going to collect? What am I collecting? Look, you finished 434,087 in the global leaderboard. That's ridiculous, isn't it? I couldn't even, my brain is not working at the moment. But anyway, I don't think we're going to see too much change in Mighty Eagle Bootcamp. Of course, it's linked to the DC Infinity Planet. I haven't even completed today's DC, so I won't be going in there with an extra bird. But maybe they'll look at reducing the cost for those Mighty Eagle hats so that we don't have to save up so many coins to spend on them. But again, who knows what Rovio have planned. We might see something totally different in the Mighty Eagle Bootcamp this year. Last of all, the clan versus clan system. I'm not going to click on there at the moment, but shout out to the foxes. The only thing new we've had in 2021 is the pick your flock thing for the CVC, where you can pick 6 birds or 8 birds or 10 birds. That's been quite interesting. I think they probably want to look at tightening up on the matches and how balanced they are. I know that there's some unbalanced matchups out there. Some clans are quite unhappy about that when they face someone that's got way higher flock power. There's a whole debate around the airplane mode, of course, which Rovio needs to address, fix, do something with. So that would be, I'm sure, this year that's going to be changing. If anything, after we've had the arena revamp last year, the next one would probably be the clan versus clan system, I reckon. For better matchups, maybe better rewards, and ways to kind of track which leaders and co-leaders are accepting or booting members, that kind of thing. There's a whole load of different things they could consider for the CVC system. So a couple of things I'd love to see is that two boss room, of course, like I said. Also, of course, we have a Feather Frenzy, we have a Black Pearl Party, and a couple of others have also mentioned the same thing. Why not something like a Glorious Gems event when our gems are doubled? So whenever we complete these daily feats, we get double the reward of gems. I think it would help out a lot of people. What we'd actually like also to see is the return of the Jetpack Run. Now, we haven't seen the Jetpack Run with our hatchlings on the mobile version for quite a while now. It still comes up on the Windows version of Angry Birds 2, but maybe, I don't know if it's some sort of something for the game mechanics, maybe it's something they can't push out to everyone, or I don't know what the score is. Guys, I've been talking way too much. Thank you for those of you that have stayed with me. Thank you for your patience. And again, thanks for all your support. Really appreciate it. I hope you're having a good start to 2022. Please stay tuned for more videos from me and the Angry Birds 2 content creators. There's quite a few of us around. Please do check out their channels. And I shall see you next time. Cheers.